On Monday, a trio of Americans took home the Nobel Prize in Medicine or Physiology for their research, concluding in so much as, I need a nap. So in this research, which was about circadian rhythms, it seems to support an idea that humans may be genetically tied to the predisposition of wanting a nap in the mid-afternoon. So with this, they studied different kinds of flies, and fruit flies specifically, and they have a gene in them called period. I don't know why it's called that, but they have instructions for releasing a sleep-related protein that seems to function on a 24-hour clock. This protein release is most active at night and then stops after an amount of buildup. So after some amount of hours, and then that would be your waking hours. However, it looks like there is kind of a mini release of these proteins sometime in the mid-afternoon. It may actually have something to do with fruit flies' need to survive. So what would happen is, in the fruit flies at least, and then this is also connected to other animals, humans as well. But for the fruit flies specifically, that is a tongue twister. They generally live in more tropical areas, warmer areas, and would need to take a nap in the shade in the mid-afternoon, because as we know, when we sleep, our body temperature goes down a little bit. If they stay awake and in the sun during those times, they might not have the same reproductive power they had before, and they might actually dry up and die. So this is a survival mechanism. It's interesting to see that my needs for naps are quantified.
You wouldn't want to dry up and die. That's
well, I'm not a fruit fly.
I'm gonna start napping.
But yeah, it seems to be connected to our genetic need. It may be saying there is a genetic need for us to take a nap.
Right, right. And also, you know, you look at places that are tropical, Central America in particular, and they have siestas. And
Yeah, this research does seem to indicate warmer areas that do have this tradition of taking a short nap. It may be related to that. It certainly seems that way.
I'm gonna call Southern California, where we live, one of those places and start taking naps.
I mean, that's gonna happen. So some of the researchers spoke out on their research, saying, if challenged with conditions that have long warm days, then fruit flies tend to have a siesta. This is also what we see in people that live in the tropics to some extent. The tendency to stay indoors, maybe take a nap or lie down when it's really warm outside, that's quite natural. It could be we're actually tricking ourselves into a summery paradigm more so than would be natural. The net effect may therefore be disruptive to our internal timekeeping, which comes with adverse health effects. There are studies that show there are real benefits to taking a nap, and part of it may be due to the fact that we're having relatively shorter nights than if we would just be exposed to natural light conditions. We may be more prone to needing those naps. In this as well, the scientists were also talking about how we kind of trick our bodies with artificial lights, artificial temperature control. You know, it could be quite warm in some buildings or overly cool. That could lead to how you perceive time and perhaps how well you sleep or how much you desire to sleep so badly, which is me, 100%.
That's me too.
When it's warm.
You hit that wall, like somewhere, usually in the afternoon, you hit that wall and you just really want to take a nap.
Yeah, I mean, it just looks like we have an internal timekeeping system, according to this Nobel Prize winning research, which may be in direct conflict with how we live our days, how we, most of us work in an office with terrible lights such as these, though I do appreciate them, but perhaps they're affecting my sleep situation. Audience, have you noticed a disruption in your circadian rhythm? And do you think we should institutionalize naps? I say yes. But please let us know what you think below, and please like and subscribe for more.